Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another spring warbler warm-up video, and this one is actually going to cover the Vireo family, which are sometimes confused with warblers. And first I'll just go over some of the general differences between Vireos and warblers. Vireos, like this red-eyed Vireo, are typically going to be a little more heavily built, and sometimes maybe almost stocky, and the bill is usually heavier than warblers. And if I zoom in here, you can see this one and all Vireos have a small hook at the end, which you won't see on warblers. Typically they have gray legs or grayish blue legs, and just in terms of movement, Vireos move a little more deliberately. They aren't really as flighty as warblers can be. So that helps to amplify their already more stocky look. And they definitely seem like slightly bigger birds than warblers for the most part. So yeah, if I start with red-eyed Vireo, they have a fairly long body, and it's kind of greenish above and pale below. And on red-eyed Vireo, the head pattern is really important, and really for most of the Vireos, the head pattern is what you're going to be looking at. But red-eyed Vireos have a dark eye line and a pale eyebrow, and then kind of this gray crown with a dark border, and you can kind of see that better from this angle where you have this gray crown, and then you just right where it meets the eyebrow has kind of a darker gray. And then of course they have a red eye, but that can be hard to see, particularly red-eyed Vireos like to hang out right in the tippy tops of trees, and they'll just sing all day. They're a very common species, and actually in Pennsylvania, where I'm from, it's like the third most common breeding bird in the state. But it's one that many non-birders have never even heard of, despite how ubiquitous they are in the summer. And just as you get a chance to study red-eyed Vireo more and more, the overall shape will become very familiar. They have sort of this horizontal posture that's very typical when they're perching, and they really have a distinctive shape. And then if I move on to Warbling Vireo, overall Warbling Vireo is just pretty low contrast, very plain overall. Typically they're going to have hints of yellow. Sometimes the yellow can be a little more strong. This one is fairly weak yellow, and I would say that's not unusual for Warbling Vireos. And the facial pattern, again, is just pretty weak overall, and they kind of have a blank look to their face most of the time. And you can see from another angle, again, very pale underneath, pale yellow, and just kind of a blank look to the face. And then a similar species would be Philadelphia Vireo. And for a lot of the Northeast, and again, I'm from Pennsylvania, so this isn't really a challenge in the spring so much as the fall. Philadelphia Vireos are very uncommon in the spring. So it's one that you have to worry about more in the fall than the spring. But Philadelphia Vireos, overall, I find that they tend to be a little more yellow, like the intensity of the yellow on the underside is usually a little bit stronger, and really you want to look in the throat area for the highest concentration of yellow, because sometimes Warbling Vireos can have pretty strong yellow, especially in the flanks, but really Philadelphia Vireo is going to have that yellow much more concentrated in the throat, and you can see that on this one as well. And oftentimes the color tends to shift a little bit more towards the orange end or kind of a golden color, as opposed to like a bright yellow. And then on Philadelphia Vireo, they also have dark lores, and that kind of contributes to an overall slightly stronger facial pattern than Warbling Vireo. And this is blue-headed Vireo. And really, again, the facial pattern is very distinctive on this species. They have a bluish-gray head and a pale throat and very strong white spectacles. And that just gives it a very distinctive look. They also have kind of a splash of yellow on the sides. And again, you can see really well on this one, that little hook to the bill that Vireos have. And then, again, this is another blue-headed Vireo. You can see that distinctive facial pattern and the splash of yellow. And even from the front, it's very apparent. Yellow-throated Vireo actually is somewhat similar to blue-headed in terms of the build and kind of the patterns, but really it's just yellow in the head and the throat, and then it contrasts with kind of a white belly. And if I show you this flight shot, you really just see the extent of the yellow. Kind of, they often have kind of a spectacled look to them, like blue-headed do, but obviously you're not going to confuse yellow-throated with blue-headed. And you can see the yellow goes down onto the chest as well. And actually, pine warbler is probably more similar to yellow-throated Vireo than the other Vireos are. So that's probably the primary confusion species. And I just did a video about pine warbler where I covered that. So I'll leave a link in the description to that if you want to check that out. And white-eyed Vireo is more of a southern species, but they certainly get up into Pennsylvania. But they have kind of yellow around the eye and on the forehead area, and pale yellow in the sides as well, and just kind of more of a gray towards the middle of the body, gray in the throat area, and also around the neck. And of course, the standout feature is their namesake white iris. And again, you can see the same features on this one, the white iris, kind of the yellow in the face and kind of above the bill there. You have pale throat, kind of pale neck, pale center of the body, and then the splash of yellow in the flanks. So that is a quick overview of the Vireo family. And if you'd like to see more details about any of the species, let me know in the comments and maybe I can do more videos about them. And if you found this helpful, please like and subscribe for more videos like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.